Without a word, this uniform also whispers of freezing troops, injured bodies, and Americans left forever in foreign fields. It documents every serviceman's courage who, by accepting this uniform, promises the one gift he truly has to give,
his life.
I wear my uniform for the heritage of sacrifice it represents and more. I wear my uniform with pride, for it represents the greatest nation of free people in the world, said by Captain Carol Dorman Kimball. This is the struggles of the military. Good morning, I am Jayla Phillips.
When thinking of the military, the active troops, the veterans, and their families, you can help but think about the word resilience. Resilience is defined as the ability to recover from setbacks, adapt to change, and keep moving in the face of adversity. The troops in the military know resilience very well. They have no choice but to become best friends with resilience. This can be seen as a bad thing. This leads us to the question, how has the U.S. military negatively affected troops in the last 20 years?
After research, I gathered that the U.S. military has a negative long-term effect on their soldiers.
Bite the bullet. Bite the bullet is a phrase commonly used in the military, which means to take the pain. It also means to put up with painful and unpleasant circumstances. Taking the pain is what the ones in the military are taught to do. It is what they have to do. Being in the military is physically and emotionally demanding. Family lives are affected. Families often get disconnected when a loved one is deployed. They miss heartfelt moments that they will never get back. For example, they may miss childbirth, graduations, birthdays, and weddings. The spouses that are left behind are left with anxiety, wondering when or if they will see their loved ones again. Not only is anxiety present, but so is inconsistency. Each year, more than 400,000 service members and their families move to a new post where they will typically stay for 2 to 4 years. Blair Paley, a clinical professor at UCLA, stated that children may be further impacted when parents' trauma symptoms interfere with their ability to parent. The trauma that is left with the soldiers carries on and affects their personal lives, which can create trauma for their loved ones because they have a hard time coping with their feelings and emotions. The transition back to civilian life is rough after leaving the military. Each year, thousands of troops are discharged from the military and are returned to civilian life. Brian O'Connor, a former Marine Staff Corps member, stated that transitioning veterans requires identity, a sense of purpose, and belonging. They are already battling mental health issues, and some battle physical damages as well.
As you can see in this graph from the Pew Research Center, it shows the veterans that have struggled with post-traumatic stress, 61% of them have trouble paying bills, 42% of them have trouble getting medical care for themselves and their families, 41% have struggled with alcohol or substance abuse, and 37% have struggled with have received unemployment compensation, and 22% have received food benefits from the government. This just shows that people are struggling when they come back from the military.
Upon returning, Karen Jape, assistant professor at the University of Tennessee, stated that
further some individuals separating do not have plans for employment and civilian life, and others lack concrete living arrangements suggesting potential poverty and homelessness upon separation.
Upon returning to civilian life, some veterans are completely lost and alone. They're unemployed and struggling to make ends meet, and they are also lacking consistency.
Turning to drugs and alcohol.
Many troops and veterans misuse drugs and alcohol and end up getting addicted to it. They take on too much stress and end up looking to drugs and alcohol to take the feeling away.
This graph from the R&D Corporation shows all of the different branches of the military. Under binge drinking, the highest above 40% is the Marine Corps, and the lowest is the Air Force, which is right at 20%. For heavy drinking, the lowest is the Air Force again, and the highest is the Marine Corps. And same thing for disorder drinking, the highest is the Marine Corps, right above 45%, and the lowest is the Air Force. And intense mental effects on the soldiers. Brown University did a research and found that in 2021, research found that 30,177 active duty personnel and veterans who served in the military after 9/11 have died by suicide, compared to the 7,057 service members killed in combat in those same 20 years.
The effects of working in the military, specifically around the time of 9/11, have left intense feelings. These feelings are so strong that many troops turn to suicide.
This is from the College Board Stimuli. In the face of seemingly hopeless circumstances, some people resemble a superhero cartoon character that runs through a brick wall. Unemotional, fearless, and hyperphlegmatic. Protected against psychological harm, they deploy quite aggressive coping mechanisms that artificially inflate their egos,
Meanwhile, others have a set of underlying propensities that make them act a little differently when under stress and pressure. Conclusion. The brains of the troops have been molded to always think like a soldier in and outside of the military. The military changes the troops and they will never be the same once they return from duty. Solutions to this is having easier access to mental health resources for the troops, having homes available for the troops when they come back, having resources for the families to have the consistency for the families. Limitations to this is it all comes down to the money. Also, not everyone is able to have access to the mental health resources that are available. Having housing available would be a big project and would cost a lot of money, and the military has strict rules when it comes to what the family can and cannot know and where they can go. This is my work study.
Will you back up one step? Thank you. All right, here are the questions for you. First one, what information did you need before you began your research? And then how did that shape the research that you did moving forward?
The information that I needed was how the military
Sorry, go ahead.
Like how the military, the negative effects, and I also needed something that I could base off of the College First student life.
Okay. And what might a real world implication be from the what might be a real world consequence of your findings that you have from your research?
I think that most people don't think about the effects of the military, so this is just showing the effects that people don't know about or see about or hear about, and it's just bringing it to light.
All right, you're done.